Welcome to edupediaworld.com. In this video, we will learn about sliding and rolling friction. What is the difference between both the kinds of friction and how do they act upon any object? So now if I tell you to push an object, what happens? When you apply a small force onto an object, the object moves to a certain distance. There is always a force of friction that acts opposite to the motion of this object, and this force of friction is called frictional force. Now let us imagine that we have wheels attached to this object. What happens if we now try to push this object? Does the object move? Yes, the object will move, but the object will move much easily as compared to when there were no wheels attached to the object. In both the cases, there is a force of friction that is acting, and the force of friction will act in the direction opposite to the movement of the object. Now, what is the difference between the two cases? The difference is that in the first case, the object, when you push the object is sliding over the surface, whereas in the second case, the object is rolling over the surface. And what happens is sliding friction is always larger than as compared to the rolling friction, and that is why the object moves easily when there are wheels attached and when it is rolling. Now let us move ahead. Let us first define what is sliding friction. So sliding friction is also called as kinetic friction. It is the force of friction between two objects when the two surfaces are rubbed against each other. Now just look at the picture as shown on the slide. In the left, the picture which is onto the left, the object is sliding over a surface. In the other picture which is onto the right, again there is an object, it is sliding over a surface. So in both the cases the objects are sliding, but the only difference is that in the first picture which is onto the left, the object is sliding over a flat surface, whereas in the other picture the object is sliding over a slant surface. So in both the cases there is frictional force that is acting. This friction is called as sliding friction. So when two objects are sliding against each other, then there is a sliding friction which is acting. Now let us define what is rolling friction. Now you just consider this wheel. If I give a small push to the wheel, then the wheel moves to the right. So there is this force which is acting in the direction opposite to the direction of the wheel. This is called as rolling friction, because now the wheel is not sliding, but the wheel is rolling. But this rolling friction is always less than sliding friction. Now the picture onto the right is self-explanatory. This shows that when the wheels are attached to any object and the object is rolling, the friction is in the opposite direction, and this rolling friction will be less than as compared to the sliding friction. So let us now define rolling friction. So rolling friction occurs when the surface of one body is rolling against the surface of another body. The origin of this force is the deformation that occurs on the surfaces as rolling occurs. So the only difference is when the object is rolling, there is a rolling friction. When the object is sliding, it's a sliding friction. Now let us consider a very simple example. You could take a wooden plank or a wooden plate and now try to push the wooden plate. The wooden plate is kept on the ground and you're pushing the wooden plate. So what will happen? The wooden plate will move to some distance. Now the same wooden plank is now kept on some cylindrical logs. And now you try to push the wooden plank. So what happens? The wooden plank will move much more easily as compared to when it was kept directly on the ground. So why is it so? Again, the reason is the same. When the wooden plank is directly kept on the ground, there's a sliding friction that is acting. And this sliding friction is large. Whereas when the wooden plank is kept on the cylindrical logs, and then if you try to give a push, then in this case there will be rolling friction which is acting, and this rolling friction is much less than as compared to the sliding friction, and that is why the object moves very easily. So we have larger sliding friction if we directly push it, and we have smaller rolling friction if we place the same wooden plank on some cylindrical object. Now let's take another example. It's also a very common example. You all must have carried your suitcases which has wheels that is attached to the suitcase. Now let's say one day the wheels that are attached in the suitcase, they are jammed, so they don't move. And what will you have to do now? What will you do is, because the wheels are not moving, you will have to drag your suitcase. Now see what happens when you drag the suitcase, the suitcase will move very slowly because the wheels are jammed. And now that the wheels are jammed, you will have to slide the suitcase. It will not roll, it will slide over the surface, over ground. In this case, the movement of the suitcase or the wheel is towards right, whereas the friction force, which in this case will be a sliding friction, will be in the opposite direction, and this will be much larger. So you'll have to pull the suitcase or push the suitcase very hard in order to drag it. Now let's see what happens if you have nice good serviceable wheels which are freely rotating. So if you try to pull your suitcase or push it, then it will be pushed or pulled very very easily because the wheels are fine, the wheels are rotating. So let's see, now if you pull it, it moves very fast. This is again because in this case there is a rolling friction which is acting. There's a small difference between both the friction. In this case, the rolling friction will be acting in the direction towards the movement of the suitcase, but this rolling friction will be much lesser as compared to the sliding friction, and that is why the suitcase is moving much easily. Now we have already learnt about what is sliding friction, what is rolling friction. We also know that in sliding friction you need to push or pull the object much harder and with lot of force as compared to the rolling friction. So it is easy to roll any object than sliding the object. Now what happens is, in our industry, huge big industries, even in our houses, this sliding is converted into rolling by use of what we call as ball bearings. So sliding is replaced by rolling with help of ball bearings. So what is a ball bearing? The image of the ball bearing is as shown in the slide. The parts of the ball bearing are also as flashed. Ball bearing has got two rings. One is called, this is the outer ring, this one is the outer ring, and then you have an inner ring. And between the outer ring and the inner ring, there are many steel balls which are separated by what are called as separators. So these ones are called as separators. So what happens is, both the rings are actually moving. The inner ring and the outer ring and the inner ring, they are moving. In between they are separated by steel balls and separators. These ball bearings are used in many equipments, like we have used ceiling fans at our home. So if you open the panel here, if you open the ceiling fan, you will see inside ball bearings. Also in case of motors, the ball bearings are used. They make our job very easy. You also must have seen in many places, whenever there are people, they are trying to move heavy weight, then they don't pull or push the weight directly just like that. They keep the heavy weight onto huge big wooden logs or steel metal logs, which are cylindrical in shape, because such heavy weights, they move very very easily over these logs. So now that we have understood what is a sliding friction and what is a rolling friction, now you will be able to appreciate why is that the invention of wheel was considered to be the most important invention in the history of mankind. It is because even the man of those times also realized the importance of wheel. He also realized that it is much easier to carry his luggage from one place to another place by using a cart and which has got wheels attached to it, rather than just carrying his luggage all through the way on his back, or just dragging his luggage or sliding his luggage. It was much easier to carry it on wheels. That is why the invention of wheel was considered to be very, very important invention in the history of mankind. I hope you must have understood what is sliding friction and what is rolling friction, even the differences between them. So thank you for watching Edupedia World.